poem that I wrote entitled Angry Black Woman. I am a black woman. I'm one of those black women who you see who always got that somebody just pissed me off look on my face. And it's not because I'm angry. It's just that I have a lot on my mind. You see, I have a right to be angry, but I'm not. You see, I can be angry for my ancestors who were taken from the motherland and bound and whipped and chained and forced to take the white man's name. I can be angry for MLK, Malcolm X, Rodney King, Stephen Biko, or a few other oppressed, beaten, broken black men of which whom some of you still don't know. I'm a black woman. And 43 years ago, it was written and thought that black families were disorganized and female-dominated. Written when we were still oppressed and hated. You see, even in 2008, it's harder for a black man to get a job than it is a black woman. And there are more of my black brothers in prison than in college. So if oppression was worse back then it is today, what grounds were there to pave the way? Who expects the black families to be organized when the fathers are all behind plexiglass? And how are they to be dominated by males when all the men are imprisoned and not in class? So I have every right to be angry. I can sit here and be angry at the fact that for some strange reason people see my history, black history, as a separate history. As if this country had two stories. I thought history was a combined recollection of all events that took place in the past. I can sit here and be angry at that my history, black history, has to be placed in a completely separate textbook, and that we segregate our history and suspect it all into 28 days, not even a month, and that's supposed to give it justice, or are we asking for too much? Is it really that difficult to address the struggle? I have a right to be irked, because for some reason stores like Walmart or Meijer choose to supply me with half of an aisle's worth of hair care products to tame this beast that sits on top of my head. Or I can be angry at the fact that somebody came up with a brilliant idea to take our hair care products and put them in a completely different store, as if it's supposed to be a convenience, when in actuality I gotta take two buses an all dang day to get there. I could be irritated by products labeled for women of color, when the last time I checked, wasn't nobody walking around clear. So even if you have not a pigment in your skin, you are still a shade, a color. Somewhere in the spectrum, your complexion exists. But I guess I'm bugging and this appeal will dismiss. I could simply complain about the fact that I'm 5'2", 155 pounds, and I've yet to find a pair of jeans not made to exploit my assets that fit my curves and my height together. You see, I am more than hips and thighs. I am not a hip-hop enterprise. I have knowledge in my mind, and I'm not required to shake my behind. I have an accent in which business settings or phone calls may be activated at the drop of a dime. I am bilingual, able to speak both love and peace. And one day, I will birth nations who will make our progress, who will make sure that our progress does not cease. I will have children, and they too will be black and proud and not hold back and say it loud. And my daughters, who will look just like me, they will have my angry face. They too will not stop in this race to make advances for this race. They will be the faces of change and not allow things to go backwards nor stay the same. They will take this world's mess and move forward with progress. You see, I am a black woman, and I have a lot on my mind.